I'm Fernando Calero, and I'm a senior research associate in the group of Bertie Göttgens at the Cambridge Stem Cell Institute. I've been working with other members of the Göttgens group, as well as colleagues in the Laurenti group, to support a wider collaborative project of the COVID-19.
I'm Nicole Mende, a postdoc in the group of Elisa Laurenti, also here at the Cambridge Stem Cell Institute, supporting Fernando and the team with these experiments.
No, we weren't. The main goal of the Göttgens lab is to understand how cells make choices to generate different cell types, in particular how blood stem cells can produce the diversity of cells present in the blood, both in adult and during development. We're also interested in what happens when this process goes wrong, for instance, in blood cancers such as leukemia.
The same is true for the Laurenti lab, who also work on blood stem cells. My research focuses on these cells outside the bone marrow, in blood and spleen, and how they contribute to blood production in healthy individuals, but also under biological stress.
Our lab has a broad experience in using genomic techniques that can process thousands of single cells in one go. When it became clear that the Cambridge immunology community was putting together a concerted effort to collect and study COVID-19 patient samples, our group contacted Professor Ken Smith to offer our expertise in single cell genomics as an additional tool for analyzing the samples.
To support this project, our lab joined providing expertise in isolating and preparing blood samples from only a few milliliters of blood, as well as looking at the types of cell surface markers that could be important in coordinating the immune response to the COVID-19 infection.
So we began our preliminary experiments at the end of April, and we are currently finishing the optimization of single-cell genomic protocols that will allow us to process over 100 patient samples at the different stages of the disease.
During this period, we also have been carefully collecting patient blood samples needed for this analysis, working with clinical collaborators at the Cambridge Institute of Therapeutic Immunology and Infectious Disease. And these samples have been tested to ensure that they can be effectively processed in the laboratory and are now ready for our experiments.
So one of the most challenging aspects has been the rapid pace at which things are changing, from the classification of patient samples to the admission of patients and how the disease is evolving. Also, to be able to carry out the research in the lab, we have extensive support from the biosafety colleagues in the Institute, who ensured that our lab spaces and paperwork was ready to process samples and that we follow strict social distancing guidelines. The complex data analysis required for single cell techniques also requires constant tweaking, so we had to make use of digital platforms to discuss this with our colleagues.
So we've already gotten some data back from a pilot experiment that we performed end of April and expect to get a second batch of data back this week. And we hope based on this, we can fine tune our protocol and analysis and then move on to the large scale patient analysis with the results coming back shortly afterwards.
This project is an extraordinary collective effort. Collaboration is always important, but this project is a great example of interdisciplinary collaboration. From the NHS staff collecting the samples to our clinical research colleagues, Professor Ken Smith and Paul Lyons, who are managing the sampling, early processing, and directing the overarching clinical questions. But our existing collaborators have also played a role, from Paul Copeland's genomic core facility in the Cancer Institute to the Marioni group, who are providing the core of bioinformatic analysis. We are also communicating with several other groups in Cambridge and Newcastle, as well as groups producing similar data to ensure that our results can be integrated across patient cohorts. We cannot forget the commercial companies that have been working alongside us, who have played an important role by providing equipment and extra discounts for this work and have managed to deliver reagents and equipment during lockdown.
Of course, we are definitely thinking of the public during this research and hope that our combined effort will shed light on the progression of this devastating disease. And we are very aware that the blood samples that we analyze are from COVID patients, some of whom will have sadly passed away, leaving grieving relatives behind. And so thus, we want to find answers for those people to better predict who is more at risk for the severe progression of the disease and discover how the immune system reacts to improve early diagnosis, but also treatment. And of course, we are also very thankful to all the volunteers from the public that give blood for our as healthy controls for our research, as these are also very crucial.
Unfortunately, due to the pandemic, we had to stop all research until last week. So we have been working on writing up studies that were undertaken before lockdown and planning the experiments that will take place once we can safely get back to the lab. We are also still in close contact with collaborators to ensure that we can be as productive as possible. But at the moment, we do not expect to feature COVID-19 in the Göttgens Group longer term plans, although this could change depending on the development of the disease. One of the projects that we are currently undertaking in collaboration with Elisa Laurenti's group is to characterize the blood system across the human lifespan, looking at both the gene expression and the cell surface markers of thousands of cells. So this work will provide a reference atlas for normal development and could be used as a reference for the COVID-19 results.
In terms of my own work, I'm interested in the biological questions related to stresses on the blood stem cell network. And thus I can see this COVID-19 research as a stepping stone to maybe also study other virus-related infections or stresses in the future once we have emerged from this crisis.